Hi, and welcome to the fourth episode of a series on the question of modern chess theory. And I'm still looking at the center. I've skipped some games that I did not find so interesting, and now I'm going to look at a game between Michael Botvinnik and Paul Keres, played in 1902 in the USSR championship. That Botvinnik won, and Paul Keres finished in the middle of the field. The game is an excellent example of how to occupy the center with your pawns and using them for later attack and thing. So let's look into the game. Botvinnik opened the game with d4. And Keres played knight f6, d4, e6, knight c3, and d5, and c takes d5, and e takes d5. Now we played bishop g5 and bishop e7. And we have a queen's gambit declined in the exchange variation. Botvinnik, he played e3, protecting the d4 pawn and opening up for his bishop. And now black castled, and Botvinnik played bishop to d3, which is a reasonable square for the bishop, looking at the h7 and. And you can see that black can't pin the knight, so it makes sense to develop the bishop first. So this pin is potentially so it's delayed, and black played knight to d7, and Botvinnik played queen to c2. Putting more pressure on the h7 pawn, and you can see that the knight is protected. So if white takes, then black can recapture with the knight, and the h7 pawn is still defended. But it's a good battery for white anyways. e8, knight to e2, and you can see that black has a little bit cramped position, and has this bishop on c8 that's not developed yet, so it's a little bit cramped. So now black played knight to f8, trying to solve his problems, and Botvinnik played the castles, c6, rook to to b1, and this could potentially be useful if you want to play b4 and a4 and try to undermine the black queen side. Keres replied bishop to d6. Another option would have been to play bishop to g4. Best is probably to play b4 and go ahead with the plan on the queen side. But d6 by Keres, and now you have to be very careful in these kind of positions, and I have fallen into this kind of idea many times, especially in blitz games, where you can see that the bishop is looking at the h2, and the pin on the queen is looking at the bishop. So if if black takes the pawn and you recapture the queen, the king, the knight can just jump and give a check, and you and the queen can pick up the bishop. So you have to be quite careful in these kind of positions. And Botvinnik, he quite reasonably played king to h1, just sidestepping all these kind of problems that potentially could happen. Another move would be b4, and then black could recapture, and now the pawns is white has double pawns on the f-file, so I understand king h1 and see as this is a really good move. Knight g6, f3, and Botvinnik, he sees, according to Lipnitsky, that there's no really weak spots in black's position, so he, instead of trying to maneuver his pieces into the weak squares, which there's none of, he will try a plan of occupying the center with his pawn, and I think you will see how effective he does that in a moment. So the game continued, bishop to e7, and protecting the knight. And Botvinnik played rook to e1, and now you can see that he prepares the center push, and he has abandoned any plans of moving, going ahead on the queen side. Knight to d7, and now the bishop is undefended, so Botvinnik takes the bishop, and black responded, rook takes e7. So now Botvinnik continued with his plan to push the e-pawn and place knight d3, and you can see that the knight looks at e4 and prepares this move e3 e4, and black continued with knight f6 taking the e4 square. So there's a battle of who controls this square the most, and Botvinnik now plays queen to f2. And the reason behind this move is to being able to defend the the d4 pawn. So when you move e4 and you take the black takes this, that this pawn on d4 will not be undefended in the end. Bishop to e6, which maybe is a slight mistake by Keres. Maybe a better move would have been to play queen to b6, and because it's looks down on the pawn chain, and also the b2 pawn. But after bishop e6, Botvinnik played knight to f6, attacking the rook, and forces more or less black to take the knight, and Botvinnik takes with again, and queen b6 now. So now the time is right for completing his plan to take the center, and Botvinnik played e4, and Keres takes on e4, and Botvinnik takes back with the f3 pawn, which he was, if you, Lipnitsky points out that it all started with this move, f3, preparing this overtaking of the center. So it quite looks so easy. So, but when I play my own games, I know it can be quite difficult to do in real games. But maybe if you try to do like Botvinnik and remember his ideas, it will be all more easier to remember the correct plans in this kind of opening. So the game continued. Rook d8, e5, advancing the center and attacking the knight. And the knight jumps to d5. And now Botvinnik seizes his opportunity and looks at this new weakness in Black's position. So knight f8, trying to defend. And now knight d6, queen c7, bishop e4, and now you can see that the f file has opened up, and it looks quite dangerous for Black already. Knight to e6, queen to h4, and now you can see that there's some threats on the h7 square. g6, stopping the idea of taking on h7, but creating new weaknesses in Black's position, especially this square and this square is now weak. So, but Botvinnik starts by taking on d5, and now you can see that C file is opened, and now White can use this to just push the queen away from the open file, and now make a rook lift to c3. And Black's position is quite cramped, and we better make those pawn greens if I can remember. So these pawns are very, very nice for White, and Black can only sit and try to defend, which is quite impossible. And Botvinnik now plays knight to f6, which is a really, really nice move. And if he takes f5, then rook e3, and queen can only move to the side, and then you can see that that would be a mistake. Like you give a check here, and it's made. So, let's see. You knight to f5, rook to e8, and now Botvinnik gives a check on h6, queen king f to f8, and now the king is placed on the open f file, and that needs to be exploited. So Botvinnik plays his queen to the excellent square f6, and there's also a potential threat of a mate. So knight has to come back and block, and now rook to f3, and you can see there's a three-piece battery on the f-file now. And the only thing Black can find is rook to c8. And now on the knight takes, and rook e6 trying to push the queen away. Queen back to g5, knight in to block on f5, and now simply knight h6. And you can see that the knight is pinned, and you can, there's a threat of playing g4. So queen to g7, and now g4, And here Keres resigned, and yeah, just an excellent game to show how to push your pawns into the center and use those pawn in the attack on the king. And I find it quite interesting that Botvinnik first prepared a queenside attack with a rook to b1, and but when he saw the opportunity to push for the center, he put the rook over to the e file and went ahead with this plan. Okay, I hope you like this game, and I will publish the analysis for this game on my blog, which is on saychess.org. So if you want to take a closer look and maybe you want to continue the analysis and look at other variations, if you think I forgot something, which I probably did, then just go to my blog, or you can also find a link in the description. So I hope to see you for more videos. Subscribe and help me support this channel. Bye.